Hi, do you want to meet Security Operations Center, Command Control Center, Surveillance Command Center, Traffic Control Room, Network Operations Center, CCTV Monitoring Control Room, Multiple Screen Solution, TV Broadcasting Center, Asymmetric Video Wall, or Build Disaster Management Center, or maybe you want this in an interactive or non-interactive way? And do you have multiple inputs like camera, laptop, and you want to see all together in one large screen? So you are confused what kind of a video wall processor to buy? My name is Milind Shinde and I am from bitsydisplays.com. First of all, thank you for watching this video. In this video, I am going to exactly explain you the different kind of processor which are available and in real life scenario where it can be used. Watch this video and I will guide you to choose the right kind of a processor for your application so that you can save lot of time and money. That's what you want, right? Also, at the end of this video, I am going to share a chart which will be a ready reckoner for you to choose the right kind of a processor. Now, first, let us understand the two types of splitters. For the basic limited configuration of a video wall, you can use passive splitter or active splitter. Passive splitter transmits signal to display without using any intelligence. Active splitter will itself modify and provide the best quality. Passive splitter, if the input is low resolution, output also will go in low resolution. Whereas active splitter will able to scale the resolution to the capacity of the display. Passive splitter comes without any upscaling. Active splitter comes with upscaling option. Passive splitter can give you only one image output as shown in this image. And with active splitter, you can have multiple inputs which can be mapped with a different display panels like shown in the below image. You can also have few set of display panels show one input like shown in this image. This can be done if it is having a standard aspect ratio, for example 16:9. But if the aspect ratio is not standard, then you have to make the content as per the video wall resolution. The only limitation is we cannot display something which is in between the panel. Here, according to your need, you can select the splitter which has to be used. But the drawback is that you can have fixed screen layout and there is no flexibility. And if you have to show one image or a video and it has a standard aspect ratio, then you can use a media player, which can be a laptop or dedicated media player or graphic system. But if the matrix is all of the video wall, then processor comes in play. If we need a flexibility, then we need to go for a video wall processor. So what is video wall processor? In short, if you have number of inputs and different type of inputs like SDI, HDMI, DVI, etc. and you want to do some processing of video inputs and show on one big display, then you need a video wall processor. So what all you can do with video wall processor? Let me show you some examples. Various display mode, up to 8 window in single display, full display, multi-signal random size display, signal overlap display, zoom in out image window size, drag image window to any position. The two modes of video wall presentation of multiple inputs are picture by picture and picture in picture. Picture by picture, this function separates the screen in half, displaying output from two different sources device simultaneously on the left and the right side of the screen. The picture in picture function separates the screen in two parts. One source device is displayed on the main screen At the same time, the other source device is displayed on the inset window. Let's see some scenarios. Scenario 1. We have 10 different inputs displayed on one video wall. Scenario 2. We have merged one input to 4 displays. Scenario 3. We have merged 2 different inputs to 8 multiple screens. Scenario 4. We have merged 2 different inputs to 8 multiple screens and rest inputs in one screen. So, which type of video wall processor to use for these kind of applications? There are two types of video wall processor: window-based video wall processor and embedded video wall processor hardware. Window-based processor has Intel Xeon processor. Embedded processor have their own proprietary CPU and circuitry for video wall processor application. Resolution: window-based processor have HDI input which can display high resolution content. Embedded processor unable to capture the high resolution than full HD. Output: window-based processor have PCI Express card and it can be scalable as per the user requirement, and we can connect up to 64 screens. In embedded processor has a standard output like DVI, HDMI, and standard output is 36 or 76 screens. Input type: window-based processor DVI, HDI, HDMI input. In embedded processor, VGA, DVA VGI switcher, HDMI, DVA HDMI switcher, and DVI input. Wall management software: window-based processor have different kind of software with specific features for your application. Whereas in an embedded processor, you cannot install any other software. It got proprietary inbuilt software, flexibility and scalability. Window-based processors are flexible in terms of software and scalable in terms of input and output. Whereas embedded-based processors are not flexible nor scalable. Redundancy: window-based processors have redundancy for mission-critical applications, whereas embedded-based processors do not have any redundancy. So, if you look overall, the window-based processors are better than embedded processor. It may be expensive little solution than embedded controller. Now, let's see a video of a virtual 360-degree online Zoom video wall for a live training, of which we were the first one to accomplish it. The 360-degree video wall brings an amazing experience and can be used for a big audience. Interactive video wall processor. There are video wall processors available in the market which can make your entire video wall interactive. And to give you an example, just have a look at this video. LED wall processor. There are video wall processors which are used for active LED. So what is LED video wall? LED video wall is made of small cabinets which has small pixels, and depending on the pixel we get the different screen resolution. The advantage of LED video wall is it's bezel-less and it comes with high brightness. So to select the correct LED video wall processor, we must find out the resolution of the screen. So let's see how to calculate the resolution in pixel. Resolution is equal to module size or cabinet size divided by pixel size. For example, will consider P2.5. The module size is 320 mm by 160 mm and the cabinet size is 640 mm to 640 mm. Module resolution. Width resolution is equal to 320 divided by 2.5, which is 128. Height resolution is equal to 160 divided by 2.5, which is 64. Cabinet resolution. Width resolution 128 multiplied by 2, which is 256. Height resolution 64 multiplied by 4, which is 256. So the resolution of the cabinet is 256 multiplied by 256, which is 65,536. Like this, we have to calculate the complete video wall resolution module. There are many high-end processors which can manage multiple inputs and give you many features like picture-in-picture and picture-by-picture. Different models of LED video wall processor. I hope you will be able to select the correct video processor for your LED video wall.